stable, and as they were passing by, they heard the angels gently singing, singing this lullaby.
Oh, This is where I get to talk. I'm Chelsea Lyman. I'm president of Advanced Women's Ensemble. The girls are about to sing for you now. Every year we get something from Mr. Boyce for Christmas, and this year one of the girls wanted to give you a plaque to hang on your wall for us, for you to remember all of us. And then we thought, since you're losing so much weight, that we need to fatten you up again. So we got you a gift certificate to the Capitol Grill so you and your wife can have a night out on the town.
Thank you. Proctor. I'm president of Patriot Singers, and this is Emily Morton, vice president of Patriot Singers. And we just wanted to take a minute to thank Mr. Boyce for every B-Day that he takes us to the land of rhythm and pleasure. And so this Christmas, we thought that we would take him to what we heard was one of your favorite restaurants, Longhorn Steakhouse.
Have had to cancel a winter holiday concert due to winter weather. And I tell you, I can't tell you the ramifications and the domino effect that this has. So I really appreciate, I think I'm only missing three or four students tonight, and that shows how these students have adjusted their schedules in a two-day period to be here tonight. And I think that they deserve a round of applause for just being here. So I appreciate it. I hope you won't mind explaining as the course director that because of the ice storm, we could not deck the halls as listed in your program. So if you'd grant me the right to change one of the tunes in the program, it's a Latin piece, it's not Christmassy, you won't understand a word they're singing anyway, but they're going to sing instead Locus Iste because we couldn't deck the halls.
Locus iste, ad eo factus est. Locus iste, ad eo.
That was fun. Yeah. Could I have those? We have a special treat for those in our audience that are fifth grade and younger. There's a surprise for you tonight. I need you to come, and if parents would like to bring their little small ones and come sit on the first row, we have a very special guest with us tonight that I think you would be interested in. Okay, it's your turn, audience. Before we sing our school song, I want to tell you, 2 years ago in an early morning in August, I don't write music, but I woke up with this tune in mind. I didn't write the tune, but the words came to my mind, "We are the Patriots." And it's just been so rewarding to see this come to fruition. And I'd like, out of respect for the spirit of independence, let us stand and sing our school song together.
Thank you.
I wanted to say something about our accompanist. Rita Maves is from Blair Road United Methodist Church as a accompanist. When the Patriot Singers sang there, this is the first time I had met Rita, but she has been such a godsend to help me freed up off the keyboard so that I can conduct, and I am very appreciative of her service tonight. Would you give Rita Maves a hand? We always end our concert with the Patriot Singers that have, our past Patriot Singers, to come and sing with our former Patriot Singers a signature piece, "The Lord Bless You and Keep You." I would ask those singers to make their way to the front. And while they're doing that, there's another special lady in this audience that I'd like to recognize that means a great deal to me. Miss Flower, would you come up here and stand beside me a minute, please? Some of you know Phyllis Louder. I tell you, are you standing? Yes, I guess you are. Phyllis Louder and I have worked together many years here at Independence, and she recently retired, although she's still in our hearts and in our mind, and we miss her a great deal. But Phyllis, without Phyllis this year, I would not have had a Patriot Singers. We had numerous scheduling conflicts, and I cannot thank her enough. And this is only an idea of the many times that she has supported me in this course program. And I want to show my appreciation on behalf of the chorus members behind me for all she's done and what she's meant to me in this chorus program. And I'm still going to miss you, Phyllis Lauer. We're going to dedicate this "Lord Bless You and Keep You" to you and to Roger and to your family. You stand right there, will you? Don't sing.